Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer. It's Thursday, April 22. Let's go through the pages. For the breviary, it's volume 2. Our hymn will be 1144. Our first antiphon is 1440. Reading 729. Canticle 1051. For the Christian prayer book, it's hymn number 4, first antiphon at 897, reading at 490, and the canticle at 691. Let's have a moment of silence and welcome Jesus into our prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird.
City of God, you are the source of our life. With music and dance, we shall rejoice in you. Alleluia. On the holy mountain is his city, cherished by the Lord. The Lord prefers the gates of Zion to all Jacob's dwellings. Of you are told glorious things, O city of God.
Babylon and Egypt, I will count among those who know me. Philistia, Tyre, Ethiopia, this will be her children, and Zion shall be called mother, for all shall be her children.
It is he, the Lord Most High, who gives each his place. In his register of peoples he writes, these are her children. And while they dance, they will sing. In you all find their home.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. City of God, you are the source of our life. With music and dance, we shall rejoice in you. Alleluia. Like a shepherd, he will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them close to his heart. Alleluia. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here he is, his reward with him, his recompense before him.
Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lamb, carrying them in his bosom and leading the ewes with care.
Who has cupped in his hand the waters of the sea and marked off the heavens with a span? Who has held in a measure the dust of the earth, weighed the mountains in scales and the hills in a balance?
Who has directed the Spirit of the Lord, or has instructed him as his counselor? Whom did he consult to gain knowledge? Who taught him the path of judgment, or showed him the way of understanding?
Behold, the nations count as a drop of the bucket, as rust on the scales. The coastlands weigh no more than powder.
Lebanon would not suffice for fuel, nor its animals be enough for holocaust. Before him all nations are so naught as nothing, and void he accounts them.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Like a shepherd, he will gather the lambs
in his arms
and carry them
close
to his heart. Hallelujah. Great is the Lord in Zion. He is exalted above all the peoples. Alleluia. The Lord is King. The peoples tremble. He is throned on the cherubim. The earth quakes. The Lord is great in Zion.
He is supreme over all the peoples. Let them praise his name. So terrible and great. He is holy, full of power.
You are a king who loves what is right. You have established equity, justice, and right. You have established them in Jacob.
Exalt the Lord our God. Bow down before Zion, his footstool. He, the Lord, is holy.
Among his priests were Aaron and Moses. Among those who invoke his name was Samuel. They invoked the Lord, and he answered.
To them he spoke in the pillar of cloud. They did his will. They kept the law, which he, the Lord, had given.
The Lord our God, you answer them. For them you were a God who forgives. Yet you punished all their offenses.
Exalt the Lord our God, bow down before his holy mountain, for the Lord our God is holy.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Great is the Lord in Zion. He is exalted above all the peoples. Hallelujah. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. If Christ is in you, the body is dead because of sin, while the Spirit lives because of justice. If the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, then he who raised Jesus from the dead will bring your mortal bodies to life also, through his Spirit dwelling in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Have you ever tasted a food that's so good that you have to ask who's the chef, or ask the cook, what is your secret ingredient? How would you like to know the secret ingredient for everlasting life? Well, in the scripture today, it says, if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, then he who raised Christ from the dead will bring your mortal bodies to life as well. Also, Jesus is our not-so-secret secret ingredient. If we have Jesus in our hearts, Jesus will justify our spirit. His spirit that dwells in us will bring us to an everlasting life filled with peace and contentment.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
He hung upon the cross for us.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
Amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will live forever. Alleluia. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. I say to you, whoever believes in me will live forever. Alleluia. Christ rose from the dead and is always present in his church. Let us adore him and say,
Stay with us, Lord. Lord Jesus, victor over sin and death, glorious and immortal,
be always in our midst.
Come to us in the power of your victory,
and show our hearts the loving kindness of your Father.
Come to heal a world wounded by division,
for you alone can transform our hearts and make them one.
Strengthen our faith in final victory,
and renew our hope in your second coming.
Let's take a moment of silence to lift up our prayers and petitions to our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear Lord Jesus, we lift up to you our prayers and petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of everyone who is praying with us this morning. We ask, Lord God, that you hear and answer our petitions as we pray.
Stay with us, Lord. We gather our prayers, and we pray the prayer your Son Jesus has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Father, in this holy season, We come to know the full depth of your love. You have freed us from the darkness of error and sin. Help us to cling to your truths with fidelity. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
May the Lord bless us, protect us from all evil, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you can join us again tomorrow.
Same time.
Same place.
Same channel.
Have a great day.